Hey guys, I'm Kendra from kendraperry.net, and today we're talking about the GI map. So there is a lot going on with the additional dysbiotic overgrowth bacteria section of the GI map, and it's not uncommon to see this section completely lit up with your patients. So what do all these mean and how do you address them? That's what we're going to be discussing in today's video. So if you guys want functional health training and all the nerdy ins and outs of functional lab testing for clinicians, plus online business strategies to get you in front of more potential clients, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified every Thursday when I post a new video. So bacteria tend to be very opportunistic, meaning that they populate and they overgrow when the environment allows them to. And it's not uncommon to see clients or patients with at least a few, if not most, of these bacteria on the results. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing three of valuable tips so that by the end of this video, you understand this section of the GI map. And guys, I have worked with hundreds of clients. I have trained dozens of health professionals in the proper understanding of the GI map. So don't worry, I got your back and I will help you understand this section so that you too can feel like an expert. So as I mentioned before, typically what you're going to see on your patient's results is lots of this dysbiotic overgrowth bacteria. And the biggest question I get is, should you actually care if these markers are present, but they are actually below their lab reference range? So the answer is yes, you still do want to address them from a functional perspective. We address everything, even if it is technically below the lab reference range, because remember, any test you do is a snapshot of a moving target. So who's to say on some other day that you're not going to find these different bacteria flagged as high? Also, we do not want to give these bacteria the opportunity to become high in the future. Tip number two has to do with the bacillus, which is at the very top of this section. So something I will tell you is that this is pretty much present in everyone you test. So this marker was added to the GI map by Diagnostics Solutions Lab January 2018. And I've seen hundreds of these tests since then, and it is present in every single person. So I actually don't give this infection much weight because at this point, I think the lab just needs to change their reference range. So hopefully they're going to do that soon because to this day, I have not seen one GI map that doesn't have this present. And I have literally seen hundreds. So if you're a practitioner who runs the GI map with your clients, let me know. Comment below and let me know what is the most common infection that you see in this section on the GI map. Because we all see a little bit different. If we can all combine our knowledge, this will help everyone. So tip number three is about how do you address each of these individual species of bacteria, especially when a lot of them, or if not all of them, are being flagged in your client. So the answer is you can't. It's actually impossible to specifically address each of these individual infections, and it's not a good idea to try to do that. Rather, you want to focus on the overall picture, which is bacterial infections, right? So there's numerous categories on the GI map of which you develop a protocol for. The overgrowth dysbiotic bacteria fit into the bacterial category. So they're likely going to respond to your typical antibacterial products like various herbs or something like high dose garlic. So one bacterial infection that does require a bit of a more unique treatment protocol is Clostridium difficile. And you can get all the details on that one in my video titled How to Manage a C. diff Infection Without Antibiotics. Okay, so now that you're a little bit more clear on the additional dysbiotic overgrowth bacteria section of the GI map, you're probably wondering about the rest of the test because there are so many markers on this test. So just make sure to grab my 16-page GI map cheat sheet for professionals. You can grab the link below. Okay, guys, so if you like this video, please let me know by subscribing to my channel. Give me a like. Share it with your fellow health nerd practitioners and make sure to comment and let me know how this video helped you. I'll see you guys in the next video.